So on this week's edition of Paint It Green, it was a solid green truck when it came in. It didn't have a whole lot of pop, but it was also an old color. It was a little faded. We're gonna put a white stripe down the side of it just to kind of break it up a little bit. So here we are, paint day. Still green, but it's a really cool color. The new color is gonna be very vibrant. I think it'll catch a lot of attention. This car, it's gonna go out in front of a lot of people, millionaires, hell, maybe billionaires for all I know. And we could either gain a lot of customers or lose them. It kind of just depends. Or it might go there and nobody really gives a about it, and it might bring $5,000.
Casey's pretty cranky. I'd say crankier than a tooth fairy in a nursing home. And right now, I think it's time to poke my head in the old booth there and see if he's on schedule or not. I dig it.
I think it looks awesome. For as fast as we did it, it looks like one of the best.
All right, so we still only got like 6 or 7 days.
We don't have a whole lot left. By the time they're done with this, we'll be done with the rest of that stuff.
All right, I dig it. Looks good. Woo!
So obviously we're very close to the end. We have very few days left. Did we get enough done? No, probably not. We're perpetually behind. We'll always be behind. It'd be nice to be closer to the end, but we're not. That being said, we're gonna have to work our tails off.
We're doing this three people. We have to come this way a little bit, guys.
Keenan and Mike finished up with the bed.
The truck is down further in the back.
That gap looks good.
And?
I'm scared.
Hit like you do all hoods.
We gotta get a jackhammer to open it up.
Yeah, the other night when you slammed that hood on the other
side. You didn't even look. He just walks by, grabs it. Wow. I headed to the truck.
There. Hey, how's it going?
So we got the engine kinks worked out in our C-10 Silverado just in time for Kyle Hicks to show up and work on our dash and door panels.
Oh, my God. Look at this. Way to go.
I'll grab some door panels.
Cool.
So this is no reflection on Sue's ability, but since this is a show quality C-10 with a high level of finish out, I needed someone who could do the work. So we called Kyle Hicks. His work fits the bill. Speaking of bill, it's steep. He may be the best in town, but he's also the most expensive.
Yeah, that's pretty nice, huh?
Way to go, Kyle. We refurbished the original dash pad and went ahead and covered it with Italian leather, did a French seam all the way down it, down the side. Eric actually did the stitch work on that.
Look at you.
We got a big piece of aluminum trim that'll cover here. We made the door panels. We wrapped all the other panels that were originally plastic or metal in leather. Full grain Italian leather on every panel that can be wrapped.
I'll tell you, the quilting on this is excellent.
Yeah.
I couldn't be happier. This is perfect. I can't wait to see him in a truck.
Yeah.
Go see that. I want to go show everybody. That's great. So when you combine the dash, the door panels, and the seats, which should arrive later tonight, Gas Monkey's laying out about 10 grand for this. And I'd say it's money well spent. The dash and the door panels are pretty impressive. If that's any indication of the work, I cannot wait to see the seat.
Benissimo. It's a Ferrari.
That's still a C-10, you
smells delicious.
Tell you what I know about Texas, and that is it's truck country, and we know trucks. This is a 1976 C-10, and we have to travel far and wide to find just the right vehicle that we're gonna build for Gas Monkey Garage. And let me tell you, that was a long 200-yard walk.
Much to our surprise, we found almost a completely original short box 76 C-10. We love C-10s. I mean, practically everyone in the shop is a truck guy. So the opportunity to take a two-wheel drive, highly optioned C-10 and stick it on the ground, well, I couldn't believe my eyes.
They're in such a good mood, they're so excited to work on it that I said, you got carte blanche. Aaron took that to heart and just took off.
We need to motivate this big son of a gun. We kind of wanted the granddaddy of them all. And while it may not be an LS9, it is an LS7, which is a 427 cubic inch small block LS engine. So we had the guys at Scoggin Dickies actually put in a much bigger cam, and then we backed it up with a 4L85. We just wanted to make sure that this much torque and this much horsepower wasn't spent laying all over the road.
This is the baddest vehicle that's ever turned out of Gas Monkey Garage, period, out the end. It is perfect from bumper to bumper, top to bottom, if you can see the bottom, because it's all the way down on the ground. Well, let's talk about the interior. You know, we like Sue. She does a good job for us, but I want to do something really different, really crazy.
The inside smells about as wonderful as a Wilson's leather store, but it goes a heck of a lot faster. The paint, well, it looks fantastic. We went with the factory green, but we decided to add a white stripe that really makes it pop. After all the kicking and screaming and whining about sanding and spreading plastic, the paint looks absolutely great.
We're into this truck for over $100,000, and I'm gonna donate it to the Cattle Baron's Ball to showcase Gas Monkey Garage. Boom. Can I get a beer now?
It's about that time.
Cool. We built this truck in the last 4 weeks, and it's absolutely perfect. It is the most unbelievable car and the most perfect one we've ever built at Gas Monkey Garage.
This truck looks like the $102,000 I shelled out on it. The bids should be running up fast.
Give me $50,000 and let's go. $50 down front, give me $60. $60, keep it going at $60. $60,000, when you go $60 here. We'll do it at $60. $60 down front, $70. $80,000 now. $80,000 now, but I'm at $80. In the back, $90. $90,000, about $80,000 in the back, now $90,000. $80,000, now $90,000, bit of a $90,000. $90,000, no money for this at $90,000.
It's no reserve. I mean, the hands got to go up in the air, and the money's got to be there. I don't know what happened, but the big fishes aren't there. I don't know if they're not paying attention. I don't know if it's the wrong color.
$90,000, what are we talking about here? Have you seen this truck? It's once-in-a-lifetime opportunity.
$85,000.
A lot of cars, he knows the value. Good, well bought, Dennis.
Thank you so much.